Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to talk about carbon cycle. Carbon cycle is a biogeochemical cycle. As the name indicates, carbon cycle is a cycle of carbon in different forms on the earth. Or it is a movement of carbon in the different form through the various components of the ecosystem. As you all know, carbon is a very important component of all living organisms, including human being. And this carbon is present in the form of organic compound. This carbon constitutes of about 49% of total dry weight of an organism. 49% means nearly 50%. So it's a huge quantity. That's why carbon is a major component of all living organisms. Then what is the main source of carbon on the earth? The main source of carbon on the earth is atmospheric carbon dioxide. Or as you all know, atmosphere or environment consisting of carbon dioxide. So this atmospheric carbon dioxide is one of the source of carbon on the earth. Anyhow, it constitutes of about only 1% of the total carbon that is present on the earth. The main source of the carbon is carbon dioxide that is dissolved in the water of the earth. That is, both fresh water and the marine water consisting of dissolved carbon dioxide in it. And that dissolved carbon dioxide constitutes of about 71% of the total carbon that is present on the earth. So, which is the main source of the carbon that is present on the earth. Now we'll study the actual carbon cycle or how carbon is cycled on the earth. As I already told, carbon cycle is a cycle, so it doesn't have any start point or the end point. For my convenience, I will start this carbon cycle at this point, that is atmospheric carbon dioxide or carbon dioxide which is present in the atmosphere. This atmospheric carbon dioxide is used by the producer. Producer means mainly plants and the algae. So this atmospheric carbon dioxide mainly used by the green plants and the algae to produce carbohydrate by the process called as photosynthesis. So large quantity of the atmospheric carbon dioxide is used by the plants and the algae to produce carbohydrate by the process called as photosynthesis. Some other amount of carbon dioxide which is present in the atmosphere get dissolved in the water of the earth. As I already told, both fresh water and marine water consisting of a dissolved carbon dioxide. And this dissolved carbon dioxide is from the atmospheric carbon dioxide. So atmospheric carbon dioxide get dissolved in both fresh water and marine water. This dissolved carbon dioxide, again it is used by the producer, that is producer that is present in the water, that is aquatic plant and the aquatic algae. So atmospheric carbon dioxide get dissolved in the water, and this dissolved carbon dioxide is used by the underwater plants and the algae to produce again carbohydrate by the process known as a photosynthesis. So both in the terrestrial medium as well as in the aquatic medium, large quantity of the carbon dioxide is used by the producer, that is plants and the algae, to produce carbohydrate by the process called as a photosynthesis. According to some estimation, annually 4 into 10 to the power of 13 kg of carbon is used by the producer to produce carbohydrate. So large quantity of the carbon is used by the producer to produce carbohydrate. Apart from that, some amount of carbon dioxide that is dissolved in the sea or ocean, that is oceanic carbon dioxide, react with the water to produce bicarbonate or carbonate. So some amount of carbon dioxide that is dissolved in the sea or the ocean reacts with the water to produce bicarbonate or carbonate. This bicarbonate or carbonate later used by some of the organisms like oyster, clams, protozoans, algae, etc. So these animals use this carbonate and they combine this carbonate with the calcium that is dissolved in the water. So they combine calcium and the carbonate to produce calcium carbonate, and they use this produced calcium carbonate for the shell formation. So they form a shell using calcium carbonate, and they use this shell for different purpose. What happens to this shell after the death of this organism? This shell after the death of this organism either get dissolved in the water or it reaches the bottom of the sea or ocean and it remains in the sedimentary form. So this sediment consists of large quantity of calcium carbonate, and it also forms a main source of carbon on the earth. So sediment which consisting of large quantity of calcium carbonate is also one of the main source of carbon on the earth. So some amount of dissolved carbon dioxide used by the animals to produce calcium carbonate. Anyhow, large quantity of both atmospheric carbon dioxide and dissolved carbon dioxide is used by the producer or the green plants to produce carbohydrate. These plants or the algae produces this carbohydrate mainly in the form of a simple form, that is glucose. Later, this glucose will be converted into complex carbohydrate like sucrose, starch, cellulose, proteins or the lipid, and it will be stored in the plant itself for the future use. From that, some amount of carbon reaches back to the atmosphere or environment in the form of carbon dioxide as a result of respiration by the plant. As you all know, plant also respires and it produces carbon dioxide as a byproduct of respiration. So as a result of respiration, plant also produces carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide is released back into the atmosphere. So some amount of carbon dioxide is cycled back to the atmosphere as a result of respiration. Apart from that, most of the carbohydrates remains in the plant body until the death of these plants or the algae. Once the plant dies or the algae dies, what happens? The body parts of this plant is feed upon by the decomposer like fungi and the bacteria, and they convert this complex carbohydrate into simpler form, and this simple form of carbohydrate or simple form of carbon reaches the soil ultimately. So some amount of carbon is released back to the environment as a result of respiration and decomposition of the plants. Anyhow, large quantity of the carbohydrate is stored by the green plants or the producer, and this stored carbohydrate is passed on to the next trophic level, that is to the animals or the herbivores upon eating on these plants. As you all know, herbivores eat on these plants, during which the carbohydrate which is stored in the plants passed on to the next trophic level. And these animals or the herbivores use this stored carbohydrate for energy production or ultimately to produce animal tissue. So during the production of energy, some amount of carbon is released back to the environment or atmosphere in the form of carbon dioxide as a result of respiration. As you all know, even animal respire and they produce carbon dioxide as a byproduct of respiration. So certain amount of carbon is released back to the environment in the form of carbon dioxide as a result of respiration. Anyhow, large quantity of the carbohydrate is converted into the other compound, and it will be stored in the animal body itself for the future purpose or for the living process until the death of the organism. Once this animal dies, the dead body of this animal is decomposed by the decomposer like fungi and the bacteria, and they convert this complex organic compound into simpler form. So during that, this decomposer releases some quantity of the carbon in the form of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, whereas the remaining carbon ultimately reaches the soil in the form of sediment or a fossil and a fuel. So both animal and plant, after death, it reaches the soil or it forms a sediment or forms fossil and fuel or deposits of coal, petroleum and natural gas. So this fossil and fuel or coal, petroleum and natural gas, which consisting of large quantity of carbon, reaches back to the atmosphere or environment upon combustion. So combustion of this fossil and fuel produces large quantity of carbon dioxide. That's how the carbon stored in this fossil and fuel reaches back to the environment. So these are the different natural way of a carbon cycle. Apart from that, human activity have great influence on the carbon cycle. Human activity like transport, deforestation, burning of fossil fuel for the energy purpose, etc. will produce large quantity of carbon dioxide, which will add on to this natural way of producing carbon or this natural carbon cycle. So that is all about the carbon cycle. I hope this video will be useful. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.